I'm here today with Pete Way, formerly of UFO, Waysted, Fastway, the Ozzy Osbourne band, and now touring as the Pete Way band. Pete, say hello to everybody and let them know how you are.
Well, hello everybody. I'm not feeling too bad, not feeling too good. I'm just looking forward to going on stage. And like the last time I spoke to Dawn, we're about to go and kick ass.
Now you're going all over the country, Pete. Tell us a little bit about your plans.
We're doing England as much as we can, and then we're going on to Japan, America, and Australia, places like that.
Wow, that's fantastic. People are going to be interested in the kind of set that they can expect. For example, how long do you play?
Play for about 45 minutes.
Okay.
It's rock.
And do you play songs from every band that you've been in?
Pretty much. Yeah.
Okay.
Phil Mogg said to me, he said, you've got to play the ones that they want to hear, which I fully understand. Well, thing is, why bother buy a ticket if you've got to listen to, doing We're All Going On Summer Holiday or something.
And you're the front man. Are you enjoying that?
It's interesting because they put it to me, the guys in the band, have got two really, really good guitar players. Obviously, bass player is fantastic, and our drummer's fantastic, and so therefore I got stuck with it. I think I got fired from being on the bass, and they went, well, you wrote the words, you wrote the songs, you can go and sing it, can't you? So I went, oh, I suppose so.
Now, I did hear from you that you play in some bass, but how does it compare being the front man playing some bass to being the guy playing the bass?
It's interesting actually, because suddenly it's a bit like might as well not have him playing bass, because yes, he's really good, but what's the point of me being really good when I want to be really good on vocals? And that is very, very hard to do. You know, I mean, when I wrote the songs, wrote them in the garden in Columbus, Ohio, 6 a.m, when I was involved with medications, personal medications. And the weird thing about it is that I really enjoyed it, but I listened back and I think, actually, that's really good songs. The only way I can recreate the music, the words, the songs, is like sing myself.
Right, well, Elita Ford found that. She looked all around for a singer. She thought, I'm the only one that can do this. And she, even though she wasn't a singer, she decided to do it because she thought that she could bring, you know, what she really meant behind the songs to the songs.
Totally. I mean, wish I could be like Bob Dylan, where he actually he's written so much stuff, but it all comes from your heart. And you know what? Playing bass is great, but one thing is being a great bass player, and I don't know, making people go, wow, what a great bass player. You know, something's more difficult to do. Singing. I mean, you'll never, ever be able to recreate the feel. If not, you become, for me, semi-amateur.
Right, and it's a challenge for you, isn't it? I mean, it's great to have a challenge. Something to actually, you know, stretch you, because obviously you've been playing bass all your life, and
I write 6-string actually.
Oh, right.
I like it, but you know what, it's a lot of pressure. It was great just being a bass player. I hid behind Phil like a brown eye on the stage. I just hide behind Michael. You can't hide from yourself.
Right, okay. Well, it's great that you're still stretching yourself. Who else is in the live band? Pete?
Well, Clive Edwards is a great drummer, been a long time friend of mine, and he plays music in exactly the same way I see it. And when I played him original songs, he goes, I really like those songs, I want to be involved. We're talking about a year or so ago before he got ill, he's in my name, you know? So, in my band, well, I've got Tim Scope actually, who's a shock to everybody because he's like one of the best lead guitar players you'll ever hear. And actually, there's Clive who said to me, you know what, you need another guitar player. So we got Tim, and Tim is fantastic. I used my very good friend who's playing rhythm guitar, Jason Paul, who works for me. He's also working in my band.
Yeah.
The reason being that Jason knows me that well. He records me, and he knows my attitude. Archer plays with us some of the time, and as you know, that he worked with Philip Liner with Grand Slam.
Yeah.
And I think they're doing like a tribute to Phil, which is a lovely thing to do.
Sure.
And I think Lawrence wants to be with us. He asked me if he could be with us, and so. Never say no. Love them all.
Now, you were wondering, Pete, when you spoke to me last time, how it was going to be for you since you were diagnosed, you know, and you were ill, and then you were going to go on this, like, long tour. Are you feeling well? Is everything working out after that?
Yeah, it's not too bad. I mean, if I was to tell you I felt great, I would be lying. I don't feel great, but I feel good when I get on stage.
Okay, well that's the main thing. I know you've always loved that. Are there any new songs from the new album? I think it's called Walking on the Edge?
Yeah, it's Walking on the Edge actually. We do Narcotics, which is kind of a bit of a joke because the song's not a joke, but it's about myself, my past, of my friends and using, and it's kind of look back and go, did I do that? But it's really, really good. And then we don't do bands, but we do. We do a song called Harley,
okay,
which somehow or other I just strummed it all three chord session. And that's great. Really, really like it.
Okay, now what's happening with the solo album? When is it due out?
In January, but we've got the Amphetamine album coming out.
Oh, what's that? What's
week.
That?
Amphetamine, it's all about amphetamine and drugs and heroin, cocaine.
And is that a Pete Way album?
Yeah.
Right, okay. So you've got two albums coming out then?
Yeah, it's like looking back and going, God, is that me? Yeah.
And is that an album of original material as well?
Yeah.
New original material?
I wrote everything.
Brilliant. Okay. Why is that one coming out before Walking on the Edge?
Because Walking on the Edge hasn't even finished.
I was going to say, because you tell me you hadn't finished it last time.
Slash is playing on Walking on the Edge.
Fantastic, we can't wait to hear that.
Every time I have to take a break, Mike Clink has to take a break. So he's like, I'm not going to get another job then. That's it, really. You know.
Okay, but we can look forward to amphetamine very shortly and then walking on the edge in January.
Me too, much.
Now, give us, so amphetamine and walking on the edge, give us a flavour of the tracks that people can expect on both of the albums.
It's exactly what it says, actually, amphetamine, the whole lot. I will never, ever write an album again that has such a condemnation or... condemnation or glorifying drugs, but it's all about drugs.
But is it about lessons learned or what is it about?
I don't know, but $750,000 later I suppose you learned a lesson. But you know what, I don't regret it.
No, well, you know, I mean, you had a lot of fun while it lasted, didn't you?
There's no fun in being in that situation.
Yeah, that's true. When it gets really tough, yeah. And I read your book, and I mean, your exploits are all detailed in your book.
Well,
a fast ride out of here.
Your wife dies, and you're spending $1,000 a week on smack, and you spend $600 a day on cocaine. It's no fun there, you know what I mean? It's a bit like I couldn't even have the ability to drive my cars.
Yes, yeah. So there comes a point where you've got to have a balance in your life, and it was way out of control. I mean, following your illness...
No, I'll tell you what, the best thing about having the money is you never lose control. What happens is you have to say to yourself, have I got the common sense to pull myself together? And also, I want to write music. I want to play in a rock band. I don't want to wait for bloody see if they need those in my
own. You got other things to do, haven't you? You got, you know, other things to finish, albums to finish, people like Slash to work with.
It's very inspirational. Well, Slash hasn't had a drink for...
Yeah, I know. Like, everybody's sober these days.
So. Yes.
That's good. You can keep yourself.
He's playing on the album. We do narcotics, but he actually did it. I've got Nikki Sixx playing on the album.
Oh,
as
that's
well.
Fantastic.
Yeah. 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 Kind of look at it. Wow, that's a bit. I think we all learn our lesson.
So following your illness as well, are you taking it a bit easier?
Very easier. I have to get told off by the band. Well, otherwise, what's the point? I don't ask people to buy tickets and have to listen to me singing something that's rubbish.
So you've got to be on top form. Got to be on top form for people.
It's the only way. What's the point of actually doing it?
Yeah. No, absolutely. Now, UFO have called it a day. Paul Raymond sadly died. I think you're going to be doing this for forever. I can't see you giving up.
Me? I hope not. Actually, they're still playing, you know, next year, playing in America and things like that. When do they have some festivals?
Oh, right, because I thought they were kind of winding it up.
Well, kind of, but he said they look old and we don't. And bless them. I love Phil. I grew up with him from 18. So, you know, but, you know, it's like, for me, it's a bit of a pop band.
Okay.
My band, you'll hear it.
Hard rock.
Hard rock is a word, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, after all your exploits, and last time we spoke, you talked about near-death experiences and things like that. You know, looking back, what have you learned out of all of this, do you think?
To think twice.
Yeah, that's it. A very, very good advice. Very good advice. All right, Pete, thank you so much for making some time to talk to us. Best of luck tonight.
Well,
Best of luck with the two new
albums.
We don't
need Matt Black because we will be down the road.
Absolutely. And we can't wait to hear the two new albums. I just heard about an extra new album that I didn't even know about, so that's just fantastic.
Well, you can learn what it's like. I've wrote it about the ghetto. I had a lot of friends who are exploring stuff like that, and things like that. I don't like to mention these things, but this is my age.
Okay, well, you are going to get the gritty real deal, it sounds like, on this record. Pete, thank you so much.
My pleasure, Tom.